Many of you have been asking me what I'm doing to take precautions with this seemingly imminent coronavirus. So if this has become a concern for you as well, allow me for a moment to make a few suggestions. Number one, first of all, let's put things in perspective. Yes, while the coronavirus is deadly, it's not too deadly. It seems to have a fatality rate of less than 2%, which is exponentially lower than most outbreaks that make global news. It does make people sick, but not in the typical ways. Last week, 14 Americans tested positive on a cruise ship in Japan, despite feeling fine. So with this particular virus, it sometimes presents with no symptoms at all. Harvard epidemiology professor Mark Lipschitz was saying, "I think the likely outcome is that it will ultimately not be containable." Lipschitz predicts that within the coming year, some 40 to 70% of people around the world will be infected with the coronavirus. But he clarifies, this does not mean that all will have severe illness. He said it's likely that many will have mild disease or maybe asymptomatic. And as with influenza, which is often life-threatening to people with chronic health conditions and of older age, most cases pass without medical care. Overall, about 14% of people with influenza have no symptoms. So as you can see, this particular virus is not unlike other viruses from the standpoint that it only has the opportunity to create illness within an already immunocompromised host. That means that if your immune system is strong, you may be in that 14% that carry the virus, but it'll still never exhibit the sickness, symptoms, or terminal illness of that disease. Or you'll be part of the 86% that will not be infected and never have any issue at all. Sounds to me like this is nothing new. You see, it's always about the soil, not the seed. The soil must be a ripe host for the seed to ever germinate. And so first, your health must be in a weakened state in order for any virus or bacteria to ever have the opportunity to make you sick. This is a principle that never changes. Health comes from the inside out, not from the outside in. So here's the most important point. If your risk of contracting the coronavirus single-handedly hinges on the strength of your immune system, then the obvious question becomes, what can I do to keep my immune system functioning at or nearly at 100%? So let me give you five key factors. Number one, keep all scheduled appointments for your adjustments. For decades now, studies have clearly indicated how much chiropractic adjustments help strengthen your immune system significantly. And if you feel like you're coming down with something, then get extra adjustments. Number two, manage your stress. Whatever it takes for you to do this, pray, meditate, go for a walk, take a vacation, etc. Number three, get adequate daily exercise. Even just a brisk 20-minute walk every day can oxygenate your body enough to support a healthy immune system. Number four, limit your intake of sugar. Sugar is the gateway to cancer, illness, and all disease. You know this already, so stand guard at what tries to enter the threshold of your lips. And number five, stock up on your immune supportive supplements, vitamin D, probiotics, immune boost packs, Ultraplex vitamin B. Supplies are limited, especially with the present CDC warning that we're under. So please take stock of what you have and what you may need and get your orders in now. Simply go to the front desk and ask them to get help for you.